To our Daily Caller audience joining us today, we are joined by former mayor of San Diego, Republican candidate for the governor of California, Kevin Faulconer. Mr. Mayor, thank you so much for joining me today. You are running in the recall election to replace Governor Gavin Newsom. There are so many issues right now in the Golden State of California: homelessness, crime, taxes, housing. Californians are fleeing, and also the issue of students are still not back in schools. But why do you believe you are the right person to replace Newsom at this moment?
Well, Jorge, it's great to be with you. And look, you hit the nail on the head on all of those issues. And I think what Californians are looking for is a governor who can actually bring real solutions, unlike this one that we have now. And look, as a proud Republican who won twice in one of the deepest blue cities in California, San Diego, the second largest city in California, I think I'm uniquely qualified to actually stand up for the principles and values that represent most Californians, and I think most important, is going to make real positive change on all of the issues that you just mentioned that are not getting addressed in California. And Jorge, I'll tell you, you're exactly right. Californians are voting with their feet. They're leaving for other states. And so that's why I'm really going to focus on, as I said, lowering our tax burden, reducing homelessness throughout the state like I did in San Diego, and also ensuring that we keep our state safe.
Now, on the issue of Californians leaving the state, Mr. Mayor, as you know the news by now, California is set to lose a House seat. This is the first time it's ever happened in the state's history after the latest census count. If you were the governor of the state, what policies would you introduce to keep businesses and families from fleeing California?
Well, that's right, and the facts are speaking volumes. People are voting with their feet. And they're leaving. You name the state, all right, you know, Texas, Nevada, Tennessee, we can go on and on, because California is not affordable. And so we have to have a governor, first and foremost, that recognizes that there's an actual problem, realizes that we have to make California competitive. And when we have a governor that sees great California company after great California company continuing to leave for other locations and does nothing about it, that's what I'm talking about. That's the sense of urgency here in California. So I'm going to be a governor that will support our California companies, not raise taxes on them. I'm going to be a governor that is going to be lowering taxes on ordinary Californians, which is why we just unveiled the largest middle-class tax cut in the history of California. Our campaign represents a sea change. All you see out of Sacramento is we want more money. We want to raise taxes. Well, we're time to say enough's enough. It's time to keep that hardworking dollars in California's pockets where they belong.
And that's actually what I wanted to talk about next, Mr. Mayor, is you just unveiled a new tax policy. You're calling it the largest middle-class tax in state history. We're going to have a graphic up for the audience. I just want to read up a couple of the lines here. It says, Californians will receive their first $50,000 income tax-free, and those filed jointly will get their first $100,000 tax-free. Individuals making less than $50,000 and families making less than $100,000 will pay zero state income tax. As of right now, the LA Times has it that your plan could help out as much as 11 million households in California. Mr. Mayor, why did you decide to come up with this tax policy, and just kind of explain just the planning behind it?
Yeah, no, Jorge, I will tell you very simply, because Californians need relief now. Our state's too expensive. It's too unaffordable. We have to make our state more livable. And you do that not by just sending a one-time stimulus check, which, you know, Gavin Newsom came out with yesterday. What Californians need is lasting tax relief. We have to get that money to stay in California's pockets. And look, this plan will represent literally, you know, in terms of things that people can, you know, grab onto: 8 months of utility bills or 8 months of groceries, 62 tanks of gas. And this is real relief to Californians, and I think it's past time, and I think that's why we're seeing so much support, because we're representing a different view. We're representing the view that says, you know, California doesn't have a revenue problem. It has a spending and waste problem, and that's why we're calling so much attention to it. And again, because people are voting with their feet and going to other states. And so this tax cut that we proposed, 99% of all California households that pay income taxes will be eligible for relief.
And one of the top issues still in the state is the issue of homelessness. The pandemic has accelerated that. Also, the closure of businesses. Between 2019 and 2020, California saw an increase of 6.8 in homelessness, which is the largest in the state's history in that time frame. Mr. Mayor, if you were elected, what issues could you put in place, right, to take on that issue of homelessness, which continues to plague the state of California?
I would take the exact same approach that I took as mayor of San Diego, Jorge, where we took a compassionate yet very firm approach. I did not allow tent encampments on the sidewalk in San Diego or over our freeway overpasses or underpasses or in our canyons and other outdoor spots. Why? Because we care about people enough not to let them die in a tent on a sidewalk. I set up a series of shelters that really had incredible results. We were the only big city in California where we actually reduced homelessness, reduced it by double digits over the last 2 years. And so I will take that exact same approach that gets people off the street. It's not about throwing money at the problem. You have to have the political will, Jorge, that says we are not going to allow people to live and die on our streets and tent encampments. Why? Because we care about you. We took that approach in San Diego. We reduced it. And guess what? It was widely supported. Democrats, independents, Republicans all saw the difference that we were making in San Diego. I'm going to take that exact same approach. And if you boil it down, I really believe that every individual has a right to shelter. I also believe that when we provide that shelter, you have an obligation to use it. And I enforced that obligation as mayor. And I'm going to take that exact same approach as governor of California.
And as well as the issue of the housing market here in California, housing costs are skyrocketing, which is leading to Californians leaving the state. A nonpartisan Public Policy Institute of California actually found that 90% of the state's residents say housing affordability is a problem, and they're seriously considering moving the state. What from a policy perspective, is there anything that you are thinking about introducing that could take on the housing cost here in California and just lower that for regular income average Americans in the state?
Well, I'm glad you quoted those statistics because they're incredibly accurate and it lays bare the problem. We need to produce more housing in California, period. I set the tone on the table as mayor that we were able to do that in San Diego. This governor talks about the need for new housing, but doesn't do actually anything about it. And I will tell you, I'm going to be a strong proponent of changing the rules and regulations in California that is holding back our ability to actually produce the housing we need. We did a landmark plan in San Diego called Complete Communities, where we had that public debate and discussion. And we said, here's where we want that growth and development. Here's where we don't. And I made it easier for you actually to construct a house. We have to make it easier. We have to cut the red tape. We have to make sure it is more affordable. And again, you have to have a governor that recognizes that there's a problem that actually needs a solution and not a governor that just gives you a bunch of rhetoric and word salad and doesn't do anything.
Yeah, I mean, there's just so many issues here in California. We could literally talk for hours and hours. But we'll leave it at that. Former mayor of San Diego, Republican candidate for governor, Kevin Faulconer, thank you so much for talking to the Daily Caller about these issues. And we'll be watching the race very closely. And to our Daily Caller audience, don't forget to subscribe and hit that bell down below so you're always notified anytime we release any new videos and content. Thank you so much for watching.